26. All right, so number 26 says, what makes the statement true? So your problem is, this is number 26. 4/5 divided by 2/3 equals 1 1/5. All right, and the question says because A, 2/3 of 1 1/5 is 4/5. So what is the key word in your answer choices? Because they all have the word of. So what is of telling us? Delilah?
Part.
Not part. Not dealing with percents. That's okay, though. All right, what does of mean in math? What does it mean? Means to multiply, right? So when you're dividing fractions, what are you actually doing? Are we actually dividing the fractions, or what do we end up doing? Ronnie? We end up multiplying. So A says, this is A, and it says 2/3 of 1 1/5. Sorry, I don't want to use is. I want to use the equal sign, is 4/5. All right, so essentially, you have to say to yourself, I have to solve this to essentially get this, right? So when you solve 2/3 times 1 1/5, do you get 4/5? Raise your hand if you did this one. Let me ask you that. Raise your hand if you did number 26. So 3, 4? All right, so everybody, what I want you to do first is I want you to solve this problem. So on your paper, write number 26, solve 4/5 divided by 2/3. It should obviously give us 1 1/5, but I want you to do your solving, your key change flip. I want you to do the whole process. Stand up when you have your answer. So if you're standing, your pencil should not be in your hand, right? So if you're not done, finish it up. 10 more seconds. Jonathan, are you finished, babe? How much more you got, Wyatt? All right, so when we go to divide this problem, do we have to do anything with 4/5 and 2/3? Do we have to do anything to those? No, because they're already what?
They're not fractions or anything.
Right, so they're not a mixed number, so there's nothing we have to do with them. All right, so then when I go through this process, I have 4/5. What do I do next? Raise your hand. What do I do next? Hamden?
Change to the other one.
Okay, then what?
What 2/3 to 3 over 2.
All right, and then you multiply straight across, and you end up with 12/10. All right, then what do we do here? Because obviously, we can't use 12/10, or leave it as 12/10, because it doesn't match our original problem. Christiana? Okay, so simplify. What are you going to divide both of those by?
2.
Okay. And you end up with 6/5. Then what do we do? Which gives you what? 1 1/5. All right, so now, you've solved your division problem. Here are your answer choices. right, so which one of these will give you the answer? So a few of us think we know. All right, let's do a stand up, sit down. All right, so stand up if you think it's A. 2/5 times 1 1/5 equals 4/5. Okay? Stand up if you think it is B. 2/5 times 2/3 equals 1 1/3. So, Mikhail, are you standing or sitting? Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Are you standing or sitting?
Sitting?
Standing. Standing. Alright. So 9 people think it is B. Alright, stand up if you think it's C. 1 1/5 times 4/5 equals 2/3. Why does D definitely not work? Why does D not work? Aiden.
Because you get 4/10 and you can't be 2/3.
Right, and is this the right number? No, it's missing a whole number. All right, so it's definitely not D. So why did nobody, let me stand up if you were unsure. Is that okay too? Because sometimes we don't know. That's okay. At least some of you guys who were unsure, you kind of took a guess, and that's fine. That's kind of the process of solving a problem, right? All right, so A. Nobody pick A. Why? Why does A not work? What do you think, Emma?
Because the answer is part of the problem, not where the answer should be.
What do you mean?
It's multiplying the 2/3 by 1 1/5 instead of 2/3, or instead of 4/5 by 2/3.
Okay, so I want to solve this problem real quick. So we know that 5 times 1 is 5 plus 1 is 6, so we end up with 6/5 equals 4/5. All right, multiplying straight across, we get what, 12/15? Can we divide by 3? What do we get?
4/5.
All right, so now let's solve, because let's solve C, because C had the least amount of people that chose. All right, so you have 1/5, which if you change it to your mixed number. All right, so when we multiply 6 times 4, what do we get? Ronnie?
24.
When we multiply 5 times 5?
25.
Can we divide those by anything? To simplify them? Will anything go into 24 and 25? Christiana, you were like, no. Why? Well, tell me about this number. What are the only two numbers that can go in that one? So 5 and 25, right? So the factors of those. Do either one of those work for 24? No. So C is actually not the right answer. Because you're supposed to get 2/3, but you can't simplify it. So it stays 24/5. Okay? So let's solve this one. So we have 4/5 times 2/3 equals 6, technically, 5ths. All right, multiply straight across. What do you get?
8.
15. Yes?
4 times 2 is 6, it's 8.
Oh, you're right, sorry. That's why I keep you guys around. So this goes 8. 15. That's what I had.
You said it.
No, I found the improper fraction. Because that's this right here is 1 1/5. Because that's what this problem is. And we were solving it over here. Does that make sense, Hannah? Because this is the original problem that was in our answer choices. All right, so we end up with 8/15. Can we do anything with 8/15? Does 8/15 equals 1 1/5? All right, so how do you solve this problem? What did we do? Right, I mean, obviously we went through the process and we solved each answer choice, but what did you end up doing to solve this problem? What did we do with every one of our answer choices?
We solved each one and see what we got and see if it made sense to what the answer we got.
Yes, that's true, but what did we do? What did we do for this one and this one and this one? And this one, what did we do? This is like, you're overthinking my question. What did you do?
Process elimination.
Yes, we've already said that. We've done all those things. What did we do to actually get our answers for each one of our answer choices? Leva.
What?
Troy.
We solved
them. Ronnie. We multiplied. But this is a division problem, y'all. We multiplied to get our answer, but this is a division problem. So why aren't we dividing? So ultimately, when you divide, you have to multiply. So I have a question for you. What made this problem so hard? What do you think made this problem so hard? Because once we did, like, each answer choice, was it that hard? Wasn't that hard? You just, first of all, you had to do a little bit of work, right? But what was the big thing I feel like, or that you think made this problem hard? William, don't pray to the math gods. They're not going to give you the answer. Because this is what this problem looks like. Those are your answer choices. So A, B, C, D. What makes those answer choices hard? Aiden. It looks really difficult with all the numbers and no what? There's no what. So that compared to my answer choices that I showed you. So let me see if I can. So these are answer choices that I wrote down. These are the answer choices you were looking at. Why is this question so much harder than what it was when we just put it on the paper? Candon?
That looks bigger than it is.
Looks bigger than it is. What's missing from your answer choices?
The multiplication symbols.
The multiplication symbols. What did they do with this problem? Instead of putting a multiplication symbol in, what did they do? They put the word of, which now we have a lot more knowledge of what of could be, right? Of could mean percents, of could mean multiply. I mean, they even have the word is. Technically, we should know what is means, right? But by putting that in there, they make this problem extremely difficult. Why is it that hard? Because all you're truly doing is solving multiplication problems to see if it actually equals that number. Okay, so what was the correct answer then? Leva. Ed. All right. Any other questions you want to go over? That was a good conversation, guys. I don't mind going over questions. Any other ones? All the other ones were easy for you guys? No? Leo, they were easy? Yes, no? Okay. All right. At this point, you're not going to be working in your notebook, but you might want to keep your notebook out to the side for your dividing fraction notes. You are going to be doing an error analysis with your group members. So go ahead, move everything out of the middle of your table except for the piece of paper that I'm passing out and the white paper that I passed out earlier. in a way just did there. You talk about it, you figure out what was wrong, and then you correct it. So on this error analysis, I don't want you to write second grade sentences. I want you to write sixth grade sentences. Because yes, you have to explain what went wrong. You have to explain how you fixed it. And just writing, I did KCF, unacceptable. You cannot write that. You have to explain. And that's why I say keep your math notebooks out so you can look back at your notes to help you give a better explanation. So each one of you have a different problem. I'm not going to zoom in on it because this is one of the problems out there. But it says read the word problem, look at the student's work and solution. Identify the error and describe it. Solve the problem correctly. Then we're going to do a gallery walk. This is where you guys are going to go to each table and look and see if they did it right. So at that period, I'm going to stop. So once you solve it on here and you do your annotating on here to identify, you're going to take your information and put it on this piece of paper just so it's bigger, because that paper is really small, isn't it? So this way you have a little bit more room to write incorrect work, identify and explain the error, correct work, and then your shared strategy. All right? So that is what you're doing on this sheet of paper. This paper is done first. You're working as a group. Please highlight, you can circle, or you can use crayons, markers, color pencils, whatever. But highlight on your small piece of paper the errors and all that. Flip that back over, I didn't tell you to go. I'm going to give you, we'll start with 10 minutes. You might need a little bit more time, but we'll start with 10 minutes. If you have questions, or you're stumped, or you're not sure, please raise your hand and ask for help, okay? All right, are there any questions before you get started? If you finish early, raise your hand, call me over there, let me check it, make sure you got everything done. Okay? And go. Definitely not what you should be discussing, is it? Come on. agenda, put it away, it's gonna be a distraction. Make sure you're highlighting, annotating, not too bright, yes. Make sure you guys have like the, guys, go ahead and like circle, highlight, annotate the, like, the error that is made. So that definitely stands out to you when you put it on to your big piece of paper. Are you looking to get into?
I'm trying to get the Carol Shrine because they're locked outside.
Oh,
we can go right here.
Okay, that's what I
needed tonight. Thank you
for letting me know. So then what error did he do though?
He
added so that needs to be stated here, he didn't state that. Okay, so you need to make sure that you say you have this is fine, but you also need to say what the error was that they did, not just how to fix it, because technically like your work and your share your strategy is where you put how to fix it. Does that make sense? I told you could not do that, right? So 8/1 divided by 5/6, and you guys were saying that the errors were used. You did keep 8/1. why, so if that's the error, which is fine, why is that a problem? What is it, you have to finish that, you can't just write one sentence, I already said that's right. So why do we have to put that second passage? It's not a trick question, why do we put it? So you have to put the second fraction in because you're technically finding the reciprocal. That means your function. For the most part, you should be wrapping up your error analysis and getting ready for me to check it, and then be adding it to, what do you need? Do you just what? No, you have to put all three, or all four of those boxes on that paper. You have 7 more minutes.
You should probably support one of the errors.
You guys have 4 minutes. 4 minutes. Just work on Imagine Math for me. Guys, have 2 minutes.
Thank you.
third group is finished. You can still be working on Imagine Math while you're standing. Last few groups, you have about a minute. Gotta get it done. You're finished working on Imagine Math. Stand up though. You guys finished, or if you're not finished, you know, then you shouldn't be on your iPad. Close your iPads. Now, the sticky notes that I put on your table, you're going to be taking those with you. What I want you to do is, in the middle of your table, I want you to have the original paper and then the one that you did. That way, when groups come to you, they can see the work that you did and the work that originally was there. So you're rotating as a group. You're only going through the rows or the tables in your row. So that's the back row, and this is the front row. Obviously, we have one less rotation in the front row just because we have one less table. But everybody will still get to go through each one of the problems. So stand up. The only thing you're taking with you is one pencil and one of the sticky notes that we're doing. All right. This is the part where you are going to rotate, and you're going to look at the work. And if you agree with it as a group, you're going to say, "We agree because." If you don't agree as a group, you say, "We disagree because." And you're leaving your sticky note once we're done with our rotation. Does that make sense? All right, is there anybody who doesn't understand what you're doing? We're all good? Okay, so everybody, you're rotating to the left. So if you're facing this way, you're rotating that way. So Troy's group comes here, Noah's group goes there, Emma's group goes to the end. So you guys all rotate, you're going to the end. Everyone go. 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 Oh, look at that. All right, I'm going to give you 3 minutes at each station. 3 minutes. Go. One minute. All right, go ahead and rotate. All right, 3 minutes, go.
I don't say. instead of.
That's not.
Oh, no, I just didn't. It was 8 times 2.
It says your judgment, it says God has helped me though. And then your judgment, God has helped me, I divided and found my tried dividing.
Yeah, you got your
dividing. They did 8 divided by 5 number 6, each is 8 over 4 times.
Okay, so sit down. If you've been to all the front tables, then sit down. Really that easy. Get on a mat right now.